Now that we've created our API view and mapped it to a URL, we can go ahead and test our new API view in the browser. So minimize Atom Editor and load up the Git Bash or terminal window that is running our profiles project Vagrant server. I still have the development server running from the last lesson, and I received this error message from when we were changing the files. This is saying that it cannot find a module named profiles api.urls. And I believe we received this error because we added the import or the include to our urls file before we created our urls file. This is fine. The Django development server just needs a refresh. So press Control C to cancel the server, and then press the up arrow to run the run server command again. So Python manage.py run server 0.0.0.0 port 8080. Hit enter to start the server again. And this time you can see that there's no error being displayed. All right, so now we can head over to Chrome and we can test our API. So if you head over to just the root URL of the project, you can see it says page not found. So this means the URL that we entered didn't match any of the URLs that we put in. If you type /API to the end and hit enter again, it says again 404 not found, because we don't have any views mapped to the /API URL. However, we do have a hello view URL mapped to a view. So let's try that. Let's try entering /API/hello view and hit enter. Here you can see it's rendered the results of our API view. So it says here, hello API, it's the name of our API view. It's got the URL and it's received HTTP 200 OK. And here it has returned the message and the list of attributes that an API view supports here that we defined in our view. Let's just look at the code and the results side by side. This is the beautiful thing about Django REST framework, is it renders the results in a nice, easy to navigate page. So you can view the actual API in the browser as you're developing. When we went to /API/hello view, Django looked at the root project's URL file. Here it found that there was a URL that begins with API here. So it matched this API part of the URL. And then it knew that it should look in the URLs file of the profiles API. So it went to the URLs file of the profiles API and it saw that there's a part of the URL called hello view. And it matched this to the hello view in our URL. So then Django knew that it needed to render this particular view, views.helloAPIView. So it looked in our views file, which comes from the root of this folder. So it looked in here and it found the hello API view. Because we used the HTTP GET request, which is the standard request when you enter the URL in the browser, it found this HTTP GET function defined here. So it ran the code in this function and then it returned this response object. And Django REST framework knows how to convert this response object into a nice looking, easy to read web page like this. So that's what it did. It took our response object, which had a message, hello, which is here, and a list, hello, an API view list, and it rendered that as a nice web page. So that's how you test the API view that we've just created. Let's move on and commit our changes to Git. Minimize Atom and minimize Chrome and load up the Git bash that is on our project that is not the Vagrant server. So the second one, the one that's just on our local machine on our project, and type git add to add the new files, git add dot. And then type git commit -am and we'll give it the message created our first API view and hit enter. And there you go, the changes have been committed. So that's how you create a basic API view. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.